All right, let's take a look at another example of factor by grouping. Use 6x squared plus 11x plus 4. So we have 6x squared, 11 of these, and 4 of those. Go ahead and try that on your own. Pause the video and try it on your own, see if it works. You can see the impracticality of using tiles when you have so many, right? So we're going to teach you how to do it algebraically using factor by grouping. So take a look. So we have 6x squared, okay? Now, that's my 6x squared. I have to move these now. So either you can put 1, 2, 3, 4 like that, or you can put 1, 2, 3 like that. So see how we can make it work. Go ahead and play on your own, and then come back so you can see if you got it. Assuming you've gotten it right, let's take a look. So I'm going to take 8 of them and put them here. And I'm going to take the remaining ones and put those 3 over here. So I took 8 of them here and 3 of them there. 8 and 3 is 11. And then the 4 singleton squares, the little red squares that I have here, I'm going to put those over here. That forms a rectangle. Very nice, doesn't it? So what's the factors going to be then? This is 2x plus 1. And 1, 2, 3, 3x, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is 3x plus 4, and this is x plus 1. So that's what it's going to look like. So 3x plus 4 and 2x plus 1, those should be our factors. Take a look algebraically here then. And that will be your answer. So this is doing it with algebra tiles. But if you want to do it without algebra tiles, so then let's see how we should do it. 6x squared plus 11x plus 4. So take the 6x squared times 4, multiply that together. That gives us 24x squared. Think of two numbers that multiply to give you 24x squared and add up to give you 11x. So clearly they're all going to have x's in them. The multiplication is positive, so both numbers have to be positive or both numbers have to be negative. What are all numbers that multiply to give you 24? 1 and 24, 2 and 12. No, that's too big. I'll give you 11. What else? Think of all numbers that multiply to give you 24 and see if you can find a combination that adds up to 11. I'll give you a few moments. Okay? So 8 and 3 is good because 8x plus 3x gives me 11x, and 8 times 8x times 3x gives me 24x squared. So we can rewrite this then as 6x squared plus 8x plus 3x plus 4. Between 6x squared and 8x, I can factor out the greatest common factor, which is 2x, and I'm left with 3x plus 4. Why? 2x times 3x is 6x squared. 2x times 4 is 8x. 1 times 3x is 3x. 1 times 4 is 4. The reason you have to write a 1 here, if you don't write any 1 here, it'll be confusing because you won't know what to factor out then. You have 3x plus 4 is the greatest common factors across these two, and then what's left is 2x plus 1. Or you can think of how you have 2x times 3x plus 4 plus 1 times 3x plus 4, which will give you 2x plus 1 times 3x plus 4. So this algebraic technique allows you to skip algebra tiles. All right, let's do a few more. All right, try that. We haven't done with subtraction yet. Subtraction means removing a rectangle out of the little one. So let's take a look. This is 2x squared plus 3x. But now I need minus 2. So what does that mean? I need the 1 by 1 squares to be taken out. So let's take them out of here. One from here and one from here. So this represents 2x squared plus 3x. So let's see if we can organize them into a rectangle. So here's my 2x squared. Remember, this can fit sideways here or vertically like this. All right, so let's see what we're going to do next. We say 4 x's, so 1, 2, 3. I'm going to take a gouge out of here and put that up there. Okay, but now remember, these had holes in them, so I'm going to have to put those holes here. Can you see? So those two holes went there, and this gouge went and sat up there. So what do you think is the answer then? So this is x plus 2, and this is 2x minus 1. Minus 1 because we took this strip out. So 2x, this is x plus 2, and this is minus 1. So that's the 2x minus 1 times x plus 2. So again, you can see how it's much, much harder when you have subtraction here. But let's see, 2x squared times negative 2 would be negative 4x squared. Two numbers multiplying to give you a negative 4x squared, adding to give you a positive 3x. So how are you going to do that? If multiplication is negative, that means one number is positive, one number is negative. So two numbers multiplying to give you 4 are 1 and 4, 2 and 2. And 2 and 2 not going to work, but 1 and 4 will work. 4, we want positive 3x, so we want 4 to be positive. 4x minus 1x is 3x, so I can rewrite it. So this is over, there's a 1x here. Between 2x squared and 4x, I can factor out 2x. So 2x times x is 2x squared. 2x times 2 is 4x. Negative 1 times x is negative x. Negative 1 times positive 2 is negative 2. And then, like before, 2x, x plus 2s minus 1x plus 2s are 2x minus 1x plus 2s. That's what we've been doing before for a long time now. Okay, so the new step is this, splitting this middle term into two so you can use factor by groupings. The key is to practice. Practice, practice, practice. That will make you more perfect every time you practice. Once you get the speed and I woke you up from sleep, you'll be able to do them even when you're groggy. That's how efficient you need to be in order to make sure you're proficient in it, in order to make sure you're masters at it. All right, let's take a look at another example, which turns out to be a perfect square. So look, let's do 4x squared, and let's take the 12x and put 6 of them here and 6 of them here. Then you can see I need 9 of them to have a perfect square. And so that's x plus x, 2x plus 3, 2x plus 3. So you can also do factor by grouping. And there's your answer then. So 2x can be pulled out of the first two terms. A 3 can be pulled out of the next two terms. And then 2x plus 3 is common between those two. And you're left with 2x plus 3. So the factors are 2x plus 3, 2x plus times 2x plus 3, which is 2x plus 3 bracket squared. That's what's telling you that it's a perfect square. You can see it here. Can you not? All right, algebraically, 4x squared plus 12x plus 9. Multiply 4x squared and 9, so we got 36x squared. Two numbers multiply to give you 36, add to give you 12. So that would be 6 and 6. So 6x and 6x, and then continue the algebraic process. So that's how you would do it algebraically if you didn't want to draw algebra tiles. So here are the steps to factor trinomials of the type ax squared plus bx plus c, or ax squared plus bxy plus cy squared, using the factor by grouping method. The first thing is to always, no matter what factoring problem you're working with, is to factor out the greatest common factor, and then work with the remaining trinomial. So once you did that, then multiply the highest degree term with the lowest degree term, and then find two numbers that multiply to give you that product, but add to give you the bx, and then factor by grouping to finish it off.